joined us in Starting Up. Now think about it, something that's often neglected in an early stage startup is business development or sales. In our third part special series titled Starting Up at Startup Saturday, that's exactly what we've decided to focus on. Well, what are the key strategies then? What is it that you must avoid? And how do you go about pricing your product? Sudhir Syal traveled to Hyderabad to get you all those answers.
Starting Up at Startup Saturday made its way to the city of Hyderabad for a special Gurukul session on sales and business development. The event attracted 80 members of Hyderabad's ever-growing startup community, and the agenda focused on answering one basic question.
We want to get an entrepreneur perspective, a VC perspective, and few startups, early stage startups perspective in terms of what they would look for, how they would go about getting that first customer.
Yes, acquiring that all-important first customer.
There are a few things, right? If you go to internet business is all about, or even mobile business.
The event kicked off with a talk by Satish Andhra of DFJ Ventures, and he gave all present the three key strategies every successful sales plan must contain.
Do your research and homework, and then founder goes out, founder becomes the initial salesperson, and then, you know, step on the gas pedal once you understand, you know, how things are working.
This was followed by a talk by Anu Acharya of biotech startup Osimum Bio.
This can change the way people perceive us.
And she was followed by Vikram Vupula, co-founder of healthcare startup NephroPlus.
Satish said the founders have to be the initial salespeople.
The former McKinsey consultant took us through the key sales mistakes every early stage startup must avoid.
The first one is, I would say, the founder has to be the salesperson for the first few leads. A lot of entrepreneurs try to bring in other people very early. Second thing is the pricing. The pricing cannot be cost-plus pricing. It has to be much more value-based pricing. Third thing I would say is targeting too many potential customers at the same time. You need to prioritize your fine target tier 1 customers. Go bang, do cold call, do hot call, whatever it takes, and spend time with them to close the sale.
And finally, the last talk of the day was by Mohan Krishna of the newly formed Hyderabad Angels. He gave us an investor's view of the key ingredients.
Experience the team and the track record, and they already have some orders on hand. You know? So even before they started, they were able to get some orders.
Every sales pitch must contain.
Am I addressing your requirement? Number one. Am I giving you the right price? Can I give you a better product in the coming days? So these are the key, I think, elements.
This brought the event to a close. The key takeaway for all those present, while product innovations might bring you the glory, it amounts to zilch if you don't roll up your sleeves for some good old-fashioned sales.
And since we're talking about getting your sales plan right, in a special event, we gave three startups the opportunity to come up with a business plan for an early-stage startup. It's the battle of the business plan. Sudhir, take it away.
Hello and welcome to Battle of the Business Plans. So we have three teams headed by three entrepreneurs in their own right. And we also have an entrepreneur here. We have Dr. Prasad of MyDrona, a very interesting education startup. So just to set the ground rules, Dr. Prasad is going to take you through his product. It's a product which he's just about to launch into the market. So he's looking for help from you guys on three separate verticals, which is product, go-to-market and business model. Dr. Prasad, show us your product and take us through what MyDrona really is.
Hi. So MyDrona is all about a portable, personalized learning platform. So after a lot of research, when we were analyzing what is the best way to present a personalized learning experience, we ended up coming up with a cool little gadget, which is a pocket device, which has a 4.3-inch wide screen, which can deliver high-quality audio, video, image or textual content. For the content creators, this particular device also provides a way to protect their content securely in the device so that they can effectively monetize from their content.
So just to summarize, yeah. It's a supplementary learning device.
Yeah.
And it's used, it's targeting both schools and colleges.
Yes.
Right? And it's obviously it's open-ended, so courses can be put in.
Yes.
Through different partners.
Yes.
Right? So why don't you take us through what the pricing model is at this point?
Yeah. So Right now, the device costs with the 4GB memory at 3,500 rupees.
So what are you looking for help from these three willing sets of entrepreneurs here today?
So I would be more interested to know, you know, what are the product level innovations that they would recommend.
Okay.
A product need not necessarily be in the device. More interested to know, you know, what are the product level innovations that they would recommend.
Okay.
A product need not necessarily be in the device. It could also be outside the device. I would also be looking for go-to-market strategy.
What do you mean when you say go-to-market strategy?
You know, what is the best way to capture the market, you know, penetrate.
Okay, so through partnerships and so on?
Through partnerships, yeah.
Okay, and business model?
So the business model is more, probably would lead more into the pricing.
Okay.
You know, what is the best way that, you know, we can monetize through this device and through this learning platform, you know.
You're wondering whether you should charge more for the device or charge more for the content,
yeah,
or keep one free and things
right.
like that.
Or there could be some other ways of, you know, using just the device as a rental platform. I don't know. You can think out loud here. I mean,
fantastic, guys. So I think you've got your brief.
The brief had been provided, and the three teams, headed by three entrepreneurs, went to different corners to brainstorm. A full half hour of jotting down their ideas, discussing and brainstorming later, they were ready to pitch their ideas to the judges, Dr. Prasad himself and Satish Andhra of DFJ Ventures. The first person to present, Ramesh Loganathan of Progress Software.
The first one is, like, we thought it'll be good, since we're talking about education here, that if there's some group sharing, group study in some form. I know there is no communication in the device, but if it's somehow enabled, where they can have some kind of a collaboration among students. That's one idea that we had on the product side. We also felt there should be a website backend, either for refreshers or information on what is updated, and maybe to get feedback. There should be some social angle to the content where there is a crowd rating. On the GTM front, we felt like we could market through free copies to school libraries. For the competitive exam preparations, which is a huge thing in, at least in India, it looks like a huge segment to target. That should be a channel to be able to go order the device and the content. On the business model, we thought the partner ecosystem is key. Tie up with the government for rural schools to supplement teachers. This seems like an opportunity, little social angle to it. Commercial ads in the content. Again, if it's a commercial device, mass wide use, mass deployed device, then like ads could be one, relevant ads, not as a revenue source.
Next up, representing Team B, Sandeep Guribanda of NephroPlus.
Language support should be very critical, be it, localized languages. It should be, your product should have that. And then you should have a webcam, basically, for the recording, real-time recording. People, students in the classroom can really record what teachers are saying. That is important, which we believe. And digital write pads, you already have USB, wherein people, if they're writing something, directly content can come on. Let's look at the go-to-market. We have few, partnerships. Like, you should look at virtual education companies out there who are actually service providers. So they should be able to use your product. You should not try to sell the product itself. You should try to sell the content. It becomes much easier for people to get the product. There's Educom, there is iTunes, and college particular database. It should be easy, very easy to come. So when you're trying to package all this content and then sell the product, I think go-to-market will become much easier. Business model per se, I think this is where the key is, right? So what you should do is you should not sell the product. Basically, people should never see you as a seller. Schools are like open to sell anything that they get. They sell school bags, they sell uniforms, everything. It's about incentives. Give a lot of incentives to the school, the administrators. They will definitely sell it for you.
And finally, representing Team C, Vijay Madhuri of Incessant Software.
Should be something that is interactive, so where a teacher is interacting with the students. So this would require some kind of Wi-Fi enablement. Also, it will help you to update the content. Because having kiosks is not a very scalable model. Go to market, basically, we are saying apart from colleges and schools, you also look at corporates, you look at government, because government is also promoting distance learning in a big way. The other thing also is, when you do a B2B channel, maybe you go for exclusive distribution rights, so that creates an entry barrier. So one of the things we had on the business model side was that for your kind of product, B2B market is much better than a B2C, which means you're kind of dealing with, you know, publishers, schools, online bookstores, these kind of people, rather than trying to sell it to individuals.
After the three pitches, the two judges compared their notes, and it was time to announce a winner.
Dr. Prasad, so many entrepreneurs coming up business plans for free. You couldn't ask for anything more.
It's very exciting, you know. As you rightly said, you know, so many plans for free. Yes. I'm very happy. Okay. So because it does two functions. One is it validates some of our previous thinking. The other thing is it would also have given us new thoughts to.
So order. Dr. Prasad, frankly speaking, what are the ideas that have impressed you the most?
From the product side, the key idea was to making it easier for the person to, you know, create content and, you know, distribute content among themselves. The suggestion was more like, you know, provide tools within the device where you can input, sure. You can record your audios, okay, or videos.
So create content using the device itself.
Yes. Okay. Their feedback was going vernacular,
right,
in a local language and targeting the lower part of the pyramid, you know, in the small towns and rural.
Okay. Satish, your thoughts on the three presenters and the three business plans that you saw?
Yeah, no, I think wonderful feedback, pretty much consistent, but I was just kind of wearing my thinking hat in terms of what should, you know, MyDrona do. I think the challenge for MyDrona is, one side I'm competing against the smartphones, right? So you've got the iPhones, Android-based devices, and Micromaxes of the world. The other side, I don't own content.
Sure.
Right? So I'm kind of really sandwiched between the rock and the hot place. So how do I add value? So in that context, I just felt, you know, if you were to make this device a platform, allow, you know, regional content, you know, to kind of get in, that flies under the radar for the big boys because they don't have volumes and they don't have focus.
So, Dr. Prasad, take us through, who's the winner?
I would say the team number two, which was in the middle.
Great. Any particular reasons why, what are the ideas that you might be implementing that they have given you?
Definitely the vernacular stuff, you know, and going to the, you know, smaller towns, rural kind of segment.
Perfect. Sandeep, can I invite you up? Round of applause, guys. Thank you. So we had a great time today here at Startup Saturday. Thank you, Dr. Prasad. Thank you, Satish. Thank you very much for watching.
We'll take a break here on the show, but coming up, say goodbye to the tiring process of filling application forms while applying to colleges. A startup fittingly called No Paper Forms is up next on Elevator Pitch.